Today we will be introducing the master budget, and we'll complete the sales and merchandise purchases budgets. A master budget is a comprehensive plan of the company's financial future, and is summarized in several interrelated budgets. The number of budgets that make up a master budget will depend on the company. Our example will relate to a merchandiser who purchases the products that they sell. There will be 9 parts to the master budget in our example, which are briefly summarized below. First is the sales budget, which forecasts sales in units and dollars for each month of the budget. Second, the merchandise purchases budget determines the amount and cost of inventory purchased each month. Third and fourth are the selling and general and administrative expense budgets, where commissions, salaries, and other expenses will be budgeted. Fifth will be a schedule of cash receipts from sales, which will forecast when sales will be collected. Sixth will be a schedule of cash payments for merchandise, which will predict when the inventory purchased from the merchandise purchases budget will be paid. Seventh is the cash budget, which will use information from all previous budgets to determine the cash balance as of the end of each month. Eighth will be a budgeted income statement to project the budgeted net income. Ninth is the budgeted balance sheet, which determines the projected balance of all asset, liability, and equity accounts as of the end of the budgeted period. In this video, we will only be completing the first two budgets, the sales budget and the merchandise purchases budget, and in subsequent videos, we will complete the remaining 7 parts to the master budget. Our master budget relates to a company called Ellison Enterprises and will be for the first 3 months of 2021. First, we will complete the sales budget. The given information relevant to the sales budget is that budgeted sales are 600 units for January, 700 units for February, and 800 units for March, and that the selling price per unit is $55 each. The sales budget is one of the simplest budgets to complete. All we need to do is list the budgeted sales in units, multiply the budgeted sales by the selling price per unit, and then we will have the total budgeted sales in dollars for each month. First, the budgeted sales in units for the first 3 months of 2021 are 600, 700, and 800, so we can copy those values into our budget. It can also be helpful to have a total column for the sales budget, so adding up the 3 budgeted sales amounts gives us 2,100 total units sold over the 3-month period. Next, we need to list the selling price per unit, which is $55. We list this price in all columns, including the total column, as it doesn't really make sense to add up the selling price to get a total. Then we can multiply the budgeted sales in units by the price per unit to get the total budgeted sales in dollars. So 600 units times $55 per unit equals $33,000. 700 times $55 equals $38,500. And 800 times $55 equals $44,000. Adding up the totals, or multiplying the total units by 55, gives us $115,500 of total sales for the quarter. That completes our sales budget. Now we can move on to the merchandise purchases budget. The merchandise purchases budget helps us determine the number of units to be purchased in each month. Before we create our merchandise purchases budget, let's talk for a moment about how a company determines how many units it should purchase in any given period. In general, there are 3 relevant values that a company should consider when deciding how many units they should purchase in any given month. First, they should consider how many units they want to have in ending inventory. Usually, this is based on some percentage of the projected unit sales in the next month. Second, they should consider how many units of product they expect to sell in the current month. These first 2 quantities together represent the number of units that the company needs for the month, often called the required units of available merchandise. Finally, they should consider how many units they already have in beginning inventory. The more units in beginning inventory, the less will need to be purchased in the current month. Putting everything together, we get this formula. The number of units to be purchased is equal to the number of units in the budgeted ending inventory plus the budgeted unit sales in the current period minus the budgeted beginning inventory. The details of this formula are summarized in the merchandise purchases budget, which we will complete now. Let's look at the merchandise purchases budget applied to our example. Let's say that the company would like to have 80% of next month's sales in ending inventory, and that the beginning January inventory consists of 600 units. Let's also assume that each unit costs $35 to purchase. Here's a reminder of the budgeted unit sales for January, February, and March from the sales budget, and now I've added April here as well. We will only be completing the merchandise purchases budget for the first 3 months of the year, but we will need the budgeted sales in April in order to create the March budget, as we will see shortly. The first part of the merchandise purchases budget calculates the budgeted ending inventory. We do this by taking the next month's sales and multiplying by the ratio of inventory to future sales, which we said was 80%. So for January, the next month's sales would be from February, which is 700 units. For February, we need the March sales, which are 800 units. And for March, we look to the April sales, which are 900 units. Then we must multiply these values by 80%, or 0.8, to get the budgeted ending inventory. When we multiply, we get 560, 640, and 720 units of budgeted ending inventory for our 3 months. This is the first of the three values we need to complete the merchandise purchases budget, the budgeted ending inventory. Next, we must add the budgeted unit sales from the current month. So simply copy down the values from the sales budget. 600 for January, 700 for February, and 800 for March. This is the second part of the formula we looked at earlier. Next, adding the first two values together gives us the required units of available merchandise, the total units that the company would like to have available in any given month. 560 plus 600 equals 1,160, 640 plus 700 equals 1,340, and 720 plus 800 equals 1,520. Finally, we can deduct the beginning inventory. For January, we have the 600 units that were listed in the given information. For February, you need to realize that the beginning inventory in February is the same as the ending inventory in January. This should make sense, right? Whatever we ended with in January becomes the beginning inventory in the next month, February. So the beginning inventory for February is the same as the budgeted ending inventory in January, which we see here is 560 units. We can use the same idea for March, grabbing the budgeted ending inventory from February, which is 640 units. Beginning inventory was the last part of the formula we looked at earlier. Now we are ready to calculate the units to be purchased. We have already added up the first two values to get the required units of available merchandise. Now all we have to do is subtract the beginning inventory to get the units to be purchased. For January, we have 1,160 minus 600 equals 560. For February, we have 1,340 minus 560 gives us 780. For March, we have 1,520 minus 640, which equals 880. Now we have calculated the number of units that the company should purchase for each month for the first quarter of 2021. All we have to do is multiply the units to be purchased by the budgeted cost per unit, which we previously stated was $35. This gives us $19,600, $27,300, and $30,800 as the cost of merchandise purchases for January, February, and March. And with that, we have completed the merchandise purchases budget. Okay, that's where we will be ending this video. Check out the next video for part 2 of our master budget example, where we will complete the selling expense and the general and administrative expense budgets.